It's a day that is connected to the Friedrich Rebbe and to the Rebbe. There is a Sichus where the Rebbe tells us how Bechlau we find that the month of Shvat, which is the 11th month, when you count the months from Nisan, so that corresponds to Yosef, who is the 11th Shevet, when you count the Shvatim, Keseder Teldoisam, when you count the Shvatim, in the order of how the Shvatim were born. But we know that for us, of course, the Iker Inyan of Yud Shvat is the Inyan of how it connects to the Rebbe, as we know the Inyan of Abba Hashemesh, Vezarach Hashemesh, that the Inyan, as Abcha Loi Shok HaShimshe Shelze, Zarach HaShimshe Shelze, that the Rebbe's light begins to shine even before Yud Shvat, certainly immediately on Yud Shvat. That's the day that marks the beginning of the Rebbe's Nesiyus. And it's interesting that this is the way the Rebbe spoke. I remember one year, the Rebbe started about, not on Beis Nissen, but I think it was Shabbos Gimel Nissen. And the Rebbe started speaking about Beis Nissen. He said, Beis Nissen does the talk. Right away, he started to speak about how this is the day which marks the beginning of the Nesiyus of the Rebbe de Shver. He said, he didn't even mention the Indian of that it was the Talmud of the Rebbe Rasha. So, for sure, not, of course, with all the big Inyanim, we're not now trying to make differences, but with all the big Inyanim, our Iker Inyan is to be focused on what is our Shlichus, Bahanagea Eileinu, how it connects us, how Yud Shvat connects us with the Rebbe. And in the last years, for sure, we found in the Rebbe's Sichus already clearly the Rebbe speaking such things minigeh to Yud Shvat, that the Rebbe said that although when you count the Shvatim Keseder Teldoisam, so Yosef, which is the name of the Friedrich Rebbe, is the 11th Shevet, and therefore that corresponds to Shvat, which is the 11th month. But if you count the Shvatim in a different order, which is the order, like the way the Shvatim traveled in the Midbar, Keseder Hamasoi, then it comes out that Asher is the 11th Shevet. And who is Asher? Asher is the Nasi of Yom Ashtei Asar Yom, Nasi Livnei Asher. Asher is the Nasi who brought his Tarban on Yud Aleph Nisan. So we see clearly how the Rebbe himself tied in the whole Inyan of Yud Shvat directly with the Avodah of the Dor HaShvi'i. There's the famous Vart that is said in the name of the Mashpia, Rabbi Greenglass, that we find in the Chita, in the She'etanya of Yud Shvat, that it concludes, Me'ayin Liesh Tomit, where we see a Kesher right away, a connection between the two Rabbeim, that Yesh is the Rosh HaTevis Yud Shvat, and Ayin is the Rosh HaTevis Yud Aleph Nisan. And here we see how the two Inyanim are tied in right away in today's Shir Tanya. So certainly, Yud Shvat is the Avodah which is Negeah to us, the Dor HaShvi'i. What is the Avodah of the Dor HaShvi'i? The Rebbe said it clearly. Vayikach Moshe et atzmos Yosef imoy, as we read, if we read in today's Pasha, that the avodah of this generation is to take with atzmos Yosef, the atzmius of Yosef, the etzem inyan of Yosef. What's the essence of Yosef, the inyan, as it's hinted in his name, Yosef Hashem li ben Acher, to take a yid who to begin with is like Acher, to begin with he's estranged. He is like a foreigner, and to transform him, that he should also be like a Bein La'aviv, to become a Bein La'aviv Sheba Shemayim, even Begolu, even in a revealed manner, it should be noticeable upon him how he is from those who are Bani Matim La'Shem Alekechem, how he is from those who are the children of Hashem. The Rebbe said in the first Maimon, how do we go about it? Al Tikra Vayikra El Vayakri. If you want to fulfill the pasuk Vayikra Hashem B'Shem Hashem Kel Olam, exactly like the way Avraham Avinu did it. It's simple. You have to proclaim the name of Hashem. You have to teach people about Eibishter. And if you want to do it the way Avraham Avinu did it, it has to be exactly like the way Avraham Avinu did it. You can't do it just by yourself. You have to get it that another Yid should do it. Al Tikra Vayikra El Vayakri. You have to make that other Yidin should also proclaim the name of Hashem. The only thing is that the Deir HaShvi today has an Isoyan that no other generation of Hasidim ever had. We can't see the Rebbe Begashmi. And even though we know that the Rebbe gives us all the teichis, and as the Rebbe said regarding the Friedrich Rebbe, that he bavarned everything in the last maimer, and similarly, the Mashpiim already have spoken about this many times, how in the last maimer that the Rebbe distributed, in the maimer of Atatatzava, towards the end of that maimer, it talks about that the Siddur Einu gave teichis afterwards, Baalik Me'atami, that there should be, we should be able to continue in the Avodah even b'koyches atzmam. But nevertheless, for us Hasidim, even though we know that we have the koyach to do the Avodah k'veyachol b'koyches atzmam, that's not a nechama. We want to be able to see the Rebbe b'gashmir. Even the fact that we know that the Rebbe says that the going to visit the Tzion is like a yechidus, and it's the same thing like a yechidus, and all the inyanim of yatir mibechayoi. But still, that's not a nechama. We want to be able to see the Rebbe Begashmi. So, today is an Eitrot, because it's Yud Shvat and it's Shnas HaShishim. And as we enter Yud Shvat and Shnas HaShishim, which is 60 years, that's a Samach. What's the Samach? A Samach could mean a lot of things. A Samach is very simply, even the way a child sees it, when you write a samach, it's a circle. It's a complete circle. That is, represents the Eir Makif. It's all encompassing. Now that we get gathered together over here, for a Hasidish of Habrengen, Yud Shvat Shnas HaShishim, what this represents is that at this time, it's the Hech site that we all become completely encompassed by the Rebbe's light, to the extent that there's nothing else in our lives, that we should be completely surrounded by it, to the extent that it should finally penetrate. Like the saying that the Rebbe explains regarding an Indian bilti rasui, regarding the Indian of Asara Batavis, the Rebbe explains the lashon Somach Melech Bavel. What's the deal? Somach Melech Bavel. That the Nebuchadnezzar surrounded Yerushalayim, and the Yilashon that the Razal used for the Matzor is not the common expression of a Matzor, but Somach. Somach is a Lashon of support. Somach Melech Bavel. That it ever brings out the positive meaning of that was that when you surround something completely, it becomes a massive of Ein Yotzei Ve'Ein Bo, like the way it was at that time. When there was a siege in Yerushalayim, it was a situation nobody could go in, nobody could go out. So likewise, as we entered we're now completed Shnas HaShishim. We've completed a circle. We've completed a samach now. So now is a massive of Ein Yotzei Ve'Ein Bo. We gotta be completely encompassed by the Rebbe's light to the extent that we're totally immersed in it, that there shouldn't be anything else in our life. And when we